Hello everyone. In this video tutorial, we are going to look into how to write a script for creating a clustering neural network in MATLAB. So first we will read the image with the help of image read command. So this is the image which we are reading. What we will do with the clustering application is that we will segregate the most prominent colors present in a picture. So as we can see, there are 7 major colors in this picture, and the neural network we will be creating will segregate or tell us that there are 7 major colors present in it. So after that, we are converting the image into a double data type, because other than the double data type, no other data type will be supported by the self-organizing map. Then we are reducing the size of the imported image. So I have reduced the size by a factor of 10. After that, I am giving the intensity of the red, green and blue in a separate matrix, and then finally concatenating in a single matrix. After that, I am creating the self-organizing map, so I can give the dimensions. I have given both the dimension as 6. Then self-org map is the MATLAB inbuilt command for creating the self-organizing map for clustering neural network. In this, we first provide the dimensions. Then 100 is the value of number of steps in the ordering phase. And 3 is the initial value of distance in the ordering phase. Hex top is the topology function, and the link distance is the distance function. These 4 parameters are the default, and even if you don't provide this in this command, it will also work. After that, I train the network and obtain the output. So output will basically tell for a particular input which neuron is the winning neuron. And then after that, I get the weights from the network. Note that the weights are basically the coordinates of the neuron. After that, I am plotting the figures. So let's run this code. After the training is complete, the window will look like this. So I have already discussed all this plot in the previous video. So this is our picture, or basically our resized picture. So as you can see, the image is blurred, and so there is an overlap of, let's say, green and black color. So the pixels at these points will have different RGB intensities. This is the zoom weight position. As you can see, the neurons represented by the blue circles are trying to reduce their distance with the green dots, that is the inputs. And on the right is the stem plot, which basically shows the same thing but in the 3 dimension. So the blue lines will show the input and the red line will show the neurons. So what you see that neurons are getting towards the clusters of the blue inputs. So click on the zoom sample hits, and as you can see that the major 7 colors are represented by the 7 neurons, like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. And other than that, we have the overlapping region created due to the image resizing. So like this, we have created a network that tells us how many prominent colors are there in the picture. You can change the topology function or the distance function, but the results will be nearly as same, because the self-organizing map will eventually be trying to reduce the distance between the neuron and the input data. So let's look into the Simulink model of this network. Type gensim. This is what our Simulink model looks like. So this is the self-organizing map, and we are supplying it with the input, that is the intensity of the red, green and blue, and getting the output. So in this, there is no processing of function. After that, there are no delays also. And then in the input windows, we can see that we have provided the 36 neurons. So these are the 36 neurons. And in this, instead of having a dot product, what we are calculating is the negative of distance. So we subtract the input from the weight and then multiply it with itself and then sum it together and get a square root to get the distance formula, and then multiply it with a negative to get the negative distance. After that, we have the net sum. So like in competitive layer, we also have bias. So in that case, we will have addition of the input weight matrix and the bias. But in this case, there's only one input, so it will not do anything. After that, we have the competitive layer. So first, what it will do is get the neuron which is closest to the input data point, and after that we convert it to the double. Then after that, we are finding the index of the neuron that is closest to the input data point. Then we return it to the output. So the scope will basically contain 2 lines, that is, one will be 0 horizontal line and one will be 1 horizontal line. And that one horizontal line will correspond to the neuron which is the winning neuron. So that is it everyone. This is how we create a self-organizing map for segregating the different colors of image in different clusters. So hope you like it, and please like, subscribe and share, and thanks for watching.